It's just another tool to help us identify a kid that might be a candidate to have a concussion. The sensors don't actually tell you if a kid has a concussion. It just tells you if they take a certain level of a hit, and the hits are measured in G-forces. So what it'll do is when they hit certain thresholds, it'll send us an alert to an alert monitor, and then we can just go and check on the kid just to make sure they're okay. It'll also tell us what kind of hit that it is. Generally, that's either a linear hit, which is straight on, or a rotational force, where it kind of gets the head kind of a twisting motion. The rotational forces are the ones that generally cause the concussions. So that's the ones we really watch out for in those cases. There's sensors through the helmet. There's sensors on the side of the helmet and up the top of the helmet. And they measure the G-forces of the hit and where the hit is located on the actual helmet. So we'll know if the kid got hit in the back of the helmet or front of the helmet, top, side. The main goal is just to identify if a kid takes a real hard shot to their head, because a lot of times those happen in the piles and we can't see them actually happen on the field. Sometimes we can see them when we go back on film. But what it'll do is it'll allow us, if we get an alert that a kid took a big hit, that we can check on them just to make sure that they're not showing any signs or symptoms of a concussion where we'd need to pull them out of play.